The visual aspects of candlestick charts allows the investor to see much more clearly what the overall investor sentiment is of a market trend. And in this case, we are able to see that there are up days and down days, and the overall market trend isn't going in any great direction with any great enthusiasm. The pullback of the past few days was stopped by a bullish Harami, telling us that the pullback wasn't going to be very strong and likely the 50-day moving average was acting as support. And today's selling sold off and then closed back up near the top of the range, still telling us that even though the market is very slow in its uptrend, it's still very indecisive in its nature. The lack of decisiveness in the market also can be confirmed by the fact that the NASDAQ, even though it's waffling in an upward direction. At the same time, the transportation index has broken a wave support level and still heading down. So there's really no overall consensus in this market of it moving in one major direction. Knowing that the market is not going to be selling off with great enthusiasm, patterns like the fry pan bottom and our recommendation of FSL is still working, and now we can use the fry pan bottom breakout as well as the individual patterns such as a doji sandwich breakout tomorrow and any positive trading, confirming that this wave is now in the next wave to the upside, which means same potential as what this wave was over here. And simple price patterns like the J-hook pattern that has the bobble, which is a failure at the first resistance level, a pullback to the T-line, and then a breakthrough of that resistance level, makes high probability target areas, such as the next major moving average, likely. So if you took your profits here, you could be buying back here knowing you have a high probability of being in the right trade at the right time. That'll be it. We'll see you in the chat rooms.